on behalf of His Majesty's Government, and to welcome you home on your return from Australia.
Lord Thompson and the people of England, it is just wonderful of you all to turn out in such numbers to welcome me here. I feel I must apologize for keeping you waiting so long. I know that's a bad advert for aviation, but never mind, we're going to do better in the future. In Australia, a well-known pilot told me he could not say in words what he thought about me and my flight, but that if he could fly me, he'd show me what he felt, and he did. He took me up and gave me such a thrilling time that he told me adequately what he thought about me. I feel exactly the same now with all of you. I want to show you, by my flying, exactly what I feel about England, how I love England and its people, how glad I am to be back home, how proud I am to be a member of our wonderful empire, and how deep is my gratitude to you all. Lord Thompson, I thank you very, very much indeed for the honour you have done me in coming down to welcome me. There are many others I wish to thank. His Majesty the King for the cable he sent me to Port Darwin, the decoration he has bestowed upon me, and the interest I am told he has taken in my flight. All those societies, clubs, and individuals who so generously sent me their congratulations to Australia. Lord Wakefield and my father, without whom I could never have done the flight. The engineers and instructors of the London Aero Club, wish yourselves good luck and good night.
Miss Johnson, may I now present you to Miss Margaret Bondfield, who, like yourself, has done a record.
I want to say that I'll be the